So hello to everyone. I come from the Institute of Special Policies. We are based in Amelie. We are an independent institute based in Ljubljana, and today I'm in the role of Urban National Dissemination Fund for Slovenia. We are not an official EU structure, but are contracted to disseminate information about the Urban program at the national level, and we were asked by the organizers today to present the Urban program. And we are kindly supported by the Urban Secretariat, which is based in Paris, to provide proper information about the program. I'll try to do my best in presenting as useful information as possible for you, but I'm always open for any more questions if, afterwards or whenever there will be some opportunity. So first, a few words about what is URBAN, what are its objectives, activities, and also what has achieved in this last period. So URBAN is part of the European Territorial Cooperation program or programs financed by the ERDF and the member states, and its main objective is the promotion of integrated and sustainable urban development in Europe. So this is a very specific focus on which all activities funded by URBAN are based on. It is what is very important to know for municipalities is that it does not fund investments in infrastructure, but it does so. It promotes sustainable urban development by facilitating exchange of experience and learning among cities. So by drawing lessons and promoting good practices, and also by supporting both urban practitioners, meaning officials at the municipal level, but also, let's say, experts. So by supporting these practitioners with different knowledge and about this system of urban development. Main strands of activities of URBAN are these three. The main activity dedicated to cities are transnational networks. These are networks of cities that form around a specific topics about specific problems that the cities face, and then exchange experience and try to forward good practices and also create some action programs to address these problems that they gather around. The second strand of activities is capacity building. So this is enhancing capacity for to urban practitioners, to policy makers, and to develop integrated participatory approaches to urban development. This is also a very important strand, because often it is not that cities don't want to do good, of course, but that they need to some knowledge how to do this. And this strand tries to address this knowledge about the ways of good policies. And the third strand is dedicated to capitalization and dissemination of what the program has achieved. So what are the results and what are these good practices that that have developed and exchanged in cities, that have been exchanged in cities. So how does this networking within these transnational networks work? First of all, they are based on some common problems. So cities with common problems on one specific topic, let's say Undine was very strongly involved in a project that was dealing with Roma integration. And they found cities with similar problems around Europe, because this is a common issue, and applied for funding. And then each of these cities had their stakeholders at the local level. They on one hand exchanged their experience on the city level, but they also needed to find partners at the local level. And this has been done through local action groups, local support groups, sorry. Which can produce local action plans on the level of the cities. What came out of this collaboration was some knowledge about good practices, about good policies, or some results, and also of course better policy management, yeah, better. How to better address these problems they can gather around. And what Urbach has offered here was funding to do this exchange of experience, to develop action plans, to develop studies. And it also offered knowledge about methods and expertise about the ways how to do it, as I mentioned before. So in this present period of Urbach, which is called Urbach 2, there have been 3 calls for these transnational networks. 52 networks have been funded, gathering more than 500 partners from basically all member states, almost all member states, and also Switzerland and Norway. And more than 5,000 local stakeholders have been involved in projects. What they have produced was these 350 local action plans addressing these problems at the local level. The second strand and the third strand have been less addressed so far. There have been, considering capacity building, there have been 2 summer universities gathering these stakeholders from the local support groups from different projects. There have been national training seminars for policymakers, and there have been also a pilot training session for elected officials, which was a very interesting one. Capitalization has produced also a lot of material, some of which you will be able to gather at the desk or registration desk. There are some very good books and flyers that Urbach has produced around specific topics, gathering material from the projects. A lot of good experts cooperate with the Urbach program in order to get the best from the projects and their results. So what are we now interested in? Most is the coming program. It has not changed a lot since the Urbach 2 program. So Urbach 3 still has more or less the same objectives and activities, structured a little bit differently, but it also has a little bit more structured these transnational networks. You can also find all this information in these flyers that are in 4 languages available here, so I will go through very quickly. And being on the innovative project. So these are the main 4 main objectives that Urbach addresses: to improve the capacity of cities, to improve design of these integrated urban strategies, to improve the implementation of these strategies, and to offer access to knowledge that has been gathered. These, you can see, are more or less the same, these main strands of activities as before. But now we have like 3 types of networks that are planned in the next programming period. So first we have action planning networks. These are networks like typical networks from this present period gathered around specific problems, cities who have some challenges, common challenges, apply for a project and apply for funding and develop a network, and they produce these integrated action plans of addressing these policy areas. But then we also have the second type of networks, which is implementation networks. These are typically cities that have already produced some plans, but are not trying to make them a reality. And they would need some kind of a support to get things done, actually. And so this is the second type of networks. And the third type of networks will be so-called transfer networks, which will be very directly trying to transfer some good practices from, let's say, more developed cities to some other cities that are still struggling to get a grasp of specific problems. What are some common features of this urban network? So who are the beneficiaries? How do the partnerships work? And what's the amount of funding available? First, the beneficiaries have to be cities, so municipalities, municipal administrations, or as we can see, also some local agencies or provincial or national or regional authorities, and also some university and research centers, but on a limited basis. Primarily, main beneficiaries have to be cities and municipalities or intra-municipal parts of government or metropolitan authorities where they exist. And then the partnership is structured as typically in EU project. We have a lead partner city, and then we have a limited number of partners, which is typically limited between 8 and 12 partners, and 6 and 8 partners in the transfer network, so in the third type of these networks. Majority of partners have to be cities, as I mentioned, but there is a possibility to have three non-city partners maximum. So non-city partners are these other beneficiaries, as we have mentioned before. All the partners have to be public bodies in Poland. There is a desired balance between partners of less developed regions and partners from more developed or transition regions. About the funding, the typical budget of a network or a project is between 600,000 and 750 euros. There are, of course, also here some share of EU funding and the national or local contribution. This local contribution has to be 15% in the less developed and transition regions and 30% in the more developed regions. We also have some, in each network has some additional envelopes, as it is called, so some additional funding. Up to 127,000 euros for expert support, for producing studies, for more expert knowledge. And there is also support by Urban Secretariat, which is ongoing during the 24 months that the project typically lasts. So there's a map of regions, but this is the same for all EU programs, so I guess you know it. And here is how typically these thematic networks get developed. First, there is a call for proposals, there is a submission of the first proposal, but this is only the first step. So here is the first point where the municipalities can join the project. Then there is this eligibility check and assessment, of course, so the first assessment of project proposals. And the selected projects get a 6-month period to develop the final proposal. And here is the second point where the municipalities can join these networks. So after the first stage of the project is already approved, you can still join the project and submitted also final proposal. If the project is selected then, and here typically the success rate is already very high, then in this second phase, then there's 2 years or 24 months to actually develop the project, the mental project. What is the provisional calendar for the next year? First call is planned to come out for this action plan network, so the first type of networks, in the beginning of 2015. I think it's planned to come out in March. And for the first calls for the transfer networks and implementation of networks will be in the second half, indeed by the end of next year. So if things go as planned, so if the operational program is approved, which is still in the European Commission at the moment, it has been submitted in mid-October to the European Commission, and if it is approved, then the first call will be in March for the section planning networks. Then there will be a deadline for submission in June, and approval of the first phase in September, and then a 6-month period. And so in March next year, 2016, there will be submission of the final proposals, and then projects will run on the network, will run for the next 2 years, so until April 2018. There is one more information if you want to. So just a little bit about the types of networks, but we can get that, we can back that to this also later on. And just again to sum up how municipalities can actually join these projects. So there are two moments to join, as you can see at the bottom. I have already mentioned the so-called step 2, so that the submission of the declaration of interest of the first stage of the project development. And then there's also this second possibility during this 6-month development phase, where usually during this period the lead partner invites some specific partners. But it is the process is actually open, but of course the existing partner has the right to select the future partners also. Well, that's it. And as I said, there are some, I think, quite nice materials available for you to take